Abeng, and today is my birthday. Generally, I'm of the opinion that giving back is an extremely valuable part of our lives. A lot of us want to be successful, and we want to be successful for ourselves, for our family, for our children, for the sake of our spouse. You know, we just want to be successful for different reasons, but we're not necessarily thinking or looking to be successful to help other people. This is why I'm here today. On my birthday, I decided to choose this day to give back, and I'm going to be sharing 21 ideas. You could hop on these ideas, make them work, and thank me later. You could start up your businesses, if you need help writing the business plan, the proposals, you know, I'm your guy, you can call me, but these are things I've thought of to solve different problems, and I think they are extremely important. I hope you like them. So, lately I've been jumping bus a lot, because having Lagos is not the easiest thing in the world. Trust me, it's not. In fact, it was so bad I had to start writing the street diaries on my blog. That's www.einstein.com. And I realized that our bus systems are not organized. So it would be really nice for us to have an organized bus system, you know, where we don't have to have conductors screaming, shouting, you know, all of that. I realized that whether or not we like it, a bus is a company. The driver is the boss. The conductor is the staff, and we inside the bus are customers. So it's extremely important how we're treated. Once you can sum up the bus system into this, it would be easier for us to structure how people should relate. I mean, I see us getting to the point where we can actually have a conductor wearing suits. I mean, I don't know, maybe I'm over dreaming it, but I think it's possible. Also, I noticed that change has really been an issue. When you're entering your cab, sometimes you might need to just jump on the cab immediately and get to where you're going, and you don't have cash on you. And ATMs might just be messing you up. Which brings me to business idea number two. I don't know how this is going to work. I think we can put it up. You know, you have the car, and then you know that part where they put the radio. A fraction of it can be made for ATM cards, so you can actually pay with your ATM card when you enter a car. Or I don't know, it's just a thought, it's an idea. I don't know how it can be worked on. I don't know how it can be expanded on. A friend of mine even told me that there's this thing they call never mind, don't worry, there's no need for me to go into that. Just know that you should be able to pay with your card, sure. Then, I think Uber taxi would actually benefit a lot trying to jump on that idea. But then it's not restricted to any brand. I'm going to just be calling brand for the sake of associations. Another idea I think we can work on, I heard it's very illegal to sell money. But then again, we have serious issues of change. Conductor is looking for change. The Okada men are looking for change. Everybody is looking for change. So how can we exchange the money and break it down? I don't, we're in Barry's era now, man. Change should be everywhere. Okay, guys, don't worry, that should be a joke. Okay, so I think someone can actually make it a service to provide change for people. By change, I mean 100 naira, break it into 50 naira, 20 naira, 20 naira, 10 naira. So that at least conductors will not be beating us on the road that you know, enter with your change, or you want to buy something and you can't because you don't have the exact denomination that they are requesting for. Serious traffic on Lagos Road, and I think a lot of other states experience serious traffic too. So I think that we could have a separate line for trucks, because I think trucks constitute a major nuisance on the road. So if we can have a separate lane for trucks, when they break down, do not affect us. Do you get, like, sometimes you just see one very mad traffic and you just see there's one truck that broke down on the road, and that's what's actually making everybody stranded. Do you get? So I think that it would be very nice for us to have a different lane, just the way we have the BRT lane for trucks. It would help reduce or decongest the, oh, let's use word, reduce, help reduce the rate of traffic in Lagos. I was also thinking that about DSTV. Now, DSTV, they don't have any major competition, right? For anybody that would want to have a digital TV, a beautiful way of establishing your digital TV, a beautiful method we can go with would be to, attach something extra. And what's that extra thing? I remember for 1 week, we didn't turn on the DSTV in the house. And it's not like, we're busy, man. Like, we just come back from work, you sleep, you wake up, you're tired. Sometimes all you want to do is just really read a book or just press your phone. There's nothing really new that DSTV is offering to us. So if you're bringing in a digital TV, one good thing that you can do is make your decoder a router. What do I mean? Your decoder should also be able to provide Wi-Fi for us. You know how you can connect. You know now, you get what I mean. Just when you connect to Smiles, Pranet, and all of that, you should be able to connect to your digital TV, connect to your decoder. So when you are not using it to watch TV, you can use it to browse. At least, so your money will be counting somewhere. I think that would be a very brilliant way to sell a digital TV and compete with DSTV in the market. That's if DSTV doesn't jump on this idea. I think it would be nice for DSTV to have an interactive billboard. Now that interactive billboard shows scores and goals of matches in play. So if you're not a DSTV subscriber, you've not bought DSTV yet, right? And you come in, I mean you're on Third Mainland Bridge and you're stuck in traffic, you could actually see what's going on, like maybe glimpse, just the way life scores shows you 3-0 and the time and all of that. It would be nice for DSTV to hop on that idea and show that. And then while they are doing that, if maybe a goal or cause or something, like a very epic goal, they could show the epic goal and go back to showing it like life scores. I think that would be a very good selling point for DSTV. I hope they are watching and I hope they learn. Also, I think that house pooling in Nigeria, I don't know if you've heard of Airbnb, where you want to travel to a new place and then you get to the place and you call up someone. You don't call up Shah, it's Airbnb, so you go by, you visit their site, somehow they'll hook you up with somebody that has a house and is willing to rent a particular fraction of that house from the particular period that you need to stay. I think Nigerians can actually adapt that. But I know that we are scared of robbers, thieves, we are very superstitious in this part of the world. So it might be very tricky, but it's actually a very good business model and I think it would be nice for us to jump on it. Another idea, hotel by the hour. So thanks to my orange guys, Mr. Lampe gave us this assignment where we're supposed to figure out a new way to create a hotel that would make it appealing to people. And one of the things that my group came up with was Hotel by the Hour, and I thought it was a very brilliant idea, so I decided to share with you guys today. So Hotel by the Hour it demands that you pay by the hour. I know for some of us, you go to a hotel by 3 a.m. maybe you finish clubbing or something, and then you go to the hotel by 3 a.m. you pay the same amount to somebody that came to that hotel 10 a.m. yesterday. Somebody that came 10 a.m. yesterday till 12 noon today would pay the same amount with you that came 3 a.m. today and left by 6 a.m. today. So I think it's actually very sad that everybody is boxed into one carton and then a price tag is attached to all of us that, oh, once you stay this time, you pay this. Depending on the size of the room, this is how much you have to pay. I think that's unfair. we all have different needs, we all have different things we want to do, we all have different time specifications that we want to spend. Sometimes we just want to cool our head, we don't want to sleep on your bed. Do you get? So we might just need maybe 1 hour, 2 hours, or we just want to do it sharp sharp and get out. Do you get? Do it sharp sharp. Well, I don't know what you're thinking, you know, but maybe it's what I'm, never mind. Anyway, so you might just want to get it done with. You might want to spend just 2 hours in the hotel. It's going to be very unfair for you to have to pay the same amount as someone that is spending 12 hours and above in a hotel. So what Hotel by the Hour demands is you pay by the hour. Like if you spend 5 hours, you would pay for the cost of 5 hours, not the cost of 24 hours. Do you understand? I think it's actually a very smart idea. And I think someone can actually take it up, refine it, and make it something really beautiful. A ready-to-eat Indomie, I think, noodles actually. You know now, Indomie, they were the first guys coming to the market, so everything now is just Indomie. But what I'm trying to talk about is noodles. I know Indomie tried to pull off something like that, but it was really, really soggy and it didn't work. I think if you can think it, it can be. So they should refine the idea. It's possible that you can make something that all we have to do is just microwave it and then it's noodles. Or we just have to put in an amount of water and microwave it and it's noodles. Something just ready to eat, man. All of us cannot just go and be sitting there and cooking in our house or something. I might be out of, at the office and I need to eat. I have a microwave. So how can you make your products compatible with microwave? Yeah, that's what ready to eat should entail. Then it would also be nice for them to sell Indomie in a cart, just the way Nescafe or Nescafe. I don't know which one is correct. Anyway, just the way they sell theirs in a cart. You make ready to eat Indomie and you make noodles on the spot so people can buy your noodles in traffic. Actually, a friend of mine gave me this idea. Like, he didn't say that they were buying it in a cart though. He said that because of the level of the traffic, people could actually order noodles and get it. I get it before the traffic moves far enough. So I was thinking if the noodles were sold in a cart, it would be nicer, it would make it, what they call it, would increase the level of mobility. Yes, we have a serious issue of waste in Nigeria. Waste, as in WASTE, waste. So it would be nice to have a very good waste disposal system where we could actually get rid of waste. Either recycling, we could actually pay people to bring their waste. I mean, this waste can be used for fertilizer. I think there are many things you could use waste for. You don't have to let it litter on the floor and constitute nuisance everywhere. I mean, it's really appalling. It's terrible. You know, there's this part of Lagos that when you're passing, maybe you're leaving Lagos from the mainland into maybe Ibadan. You're going towards that Ibadan road. The smell that hits you, I can't even talk about it. It's like they use waste to build houses. I'm exaggerating, but it's that bad. So I think if we can tackle the issue of waste disposal in Nigeria, it's going to go a long way. Then, I noticed. So, you know how in Yankee, let me not just say Yankee, in a whole lot of places, when there's an emergency, say somebody is about to die, or somebody is... you just have to call 911, right? Just 911. That's very easy, right? But in Nigeria, if something is happening, there's no number you can just call. So it would be really nice for us to have. A customer service, like a company that operates like customer service, and they have a particular number. So no matter what the problem is, you're pregnant, you robbery in your area, fire, anything, you could just call it. When you call that number, they would pick and redirect you to the appropriate place that the emergency warrants. So if you need fire service, they'll be able to redirect you. So they are the ones with all the plenty numbers in Nigeria is applying us with. But you will be having just one number that everybody can reach you with. Just like customer service. Yes. Customer service actually is an idea. Now, when you're passing Terminal Bridge, there's this billboard, Ethel. It's so static. I mean, anyway, people say that when you see Ethel billboard, you know, oh, you're almost at the end of traffic. But really, I think it could be more interactive. I think if you could come up with weekly puzzles that people look forward to, it doesn't have to be serious puzzle. It could be something like 4 picks, 1 word. You just put it up to task people's brain. They look forward to it every week. Some people, it might take people 3 days to figure it out. Somebody might show their friend. You get like one thing might lead to another, and then it just gives people a reason to look at your billboard. Truth is, ads that are always about your product doesn't really sell. That was one thing I actually learned. When you sell emotion, it sells better than when you're just selling your product. So sell an emotion. Sell fun. You're the smartphone network at Airtel. So if you're a smartphone network, what's so smart about you? Like, do something smart, man. Make me feel smart too. You get, you might decide to reward, you might, people might just do it out of fun. You get, no matter how it works, man, I just think that we can actually make that work. You're the smartphone network, so make people feel smart or connect to your smart guys that have phones. That would be good. But anyway, but I think that the ad should be more creative. Plus, still talking about Terminal Bridge, there's this water area. When you're stuck in traffic, you can always see it. And then you wish you had a boat or something. Conga has, or Conga is known for express delivery. So if you guys can jump on that, that would actually be very nice. Reflect and add on water. Say traffic can't stop you. Something creative, something water friendly. I mean, maybe your guy could be on a bike and he's moving on the water. Not a real guy, like just image impression by light. Moving on the water and saying we can't be stopped by them, we can't be stopped by traffic. Or something, you know, something funny, something catchy, something different. It would really come in handy. Because I think our ads are not as amazing as they should be. We have more potential than we let ourselves believe that we have. Okay. Stop. Stop. Since I was young, I've been hearing star, shine, bobo, star. But in all honesty, nothing is that bright anymore about them because there's nothing so innovative. It would be really nice for you guys to, not just start, but anybody can hop on the idea, as I said before, but it would be really nice for us to have a glow-in-the-dark beer. So let's say due to health reasons, it's not advisable to have a glow-in-the-dark beer because it might hurt people. I think it's possible though, but in case it's not possible, we could have bottles that once you pour, once it's full, it glows, and then as you're drinking and it's coming down, the part that is containing the liquid is still glowing, but the part that doesn't have the liquid is now dark. So it's fascinating. I think if you have a campaign and you have a show, which Star likes to do a lot, and you have people holding those glowing dark bottles, it would be really beautiful. I think it's also going to be very innovative, and it's going to be something that we've not seen before. Also, Glow can, which is my next idea, Glow, as in Glow.com, can actually jump on this idea because it's glow in the dark. So it could be glow with pride or something. You know, associations matter. So I think that if Glow can partner with Star to get this done, that would be very brilliant. Another beautiful thing we can do would be on stage performance. Afropolitan Vibes is already doing it, but I'm so tired of Nigerians or Africans in general lip syncing. I'm not saying lip syncing is bad, but show us you can sing outside the studio now. Every day you come and you'll be doing the same. As in, I don't know if anybody else feels my pain, but it's tiring. Do you get like lip syncing is tiring? Come perform, show us that you're a performer. As in, even if you don't have the voice, there's a way you can carry yourself, dance, we'll love you. But lip syncing every time is very annoying. Imagine I pay like 200 million to come and sing for me. Okay, maybe not to that. Let's say 5 million. Pay 5 million to come and sing for me. And I play your song that could have played whether you were there or not. And you'll be jumping up and down. What's that? Please, lip syncing, I think, should be banned at awards. I don't know how they're going to put it out. There should be some kind of regulation. It's just an idea, so I don't know. And I respect Afropolitan Vibes for what they're doing, and I hope that they never stop. Which brings me to my next idea, Art Heaven. Art Heaven is supposed to be a hub for art. So everything art can be found there when it comes to dancing, music, musical instruments, drawing, a whole lot of stuff, man. You can just find anything art there, and then you should have like the biggest performance stage where you could have drama, you can have shows, you could rent, you get, and it should still be the hub where all this musical instruments or dance instruments or whatever facilitates art should be sold. So it would be really nice if you could have that. It would also serve as a tourist center if it is actually well executed. Now, Aboki guys are one of the, I don't know, it's like one of the maddest franchises. Anyway, you see an Aboki guy, somehow they just spread like virus, and they know exactly what you need. They're very entrepreneurial or enterprising, any word I mean, please. So they are, and I think it's actually really nice that they do what they do. But if someone can pick up their Aboki model and modernize it and make it something beautiful, it would be nice. That's Aboki as a company. See, things, it's an opening. Do you get? Imagine you are managing 7 Aboki stores. You pick Hausa man from nowhere and make him and again tell him, okay, oh yeah, you want to start shop, she? Okay, start. This is your store. You're going to be remitting maybe 10,000 naira every week or 5,000 naira every week or something. I don't know, but I think it can work. As I said before, the reason I'm making this video is so we can have ideas, share them, make them work. We could actually leverage on them. They could serve as ideas that would bring up other ideas. They could serve as something to just inspire you, to help you touch a fraction of your business or something you're already working on. I studied the American model and I realized that America is very branded. They don't sing their national anthem anyhow. They respect their flag. America is somewhere that they take pee. I mean, even you as a foreigner, if you go to America, you take America pee. They've so structured their lives to America. See, America is a brand. America is a brand. But they don't have vision, is it vision statement, that mission statement? They sell an American dream. The dream that you can come into America, is a land of possibilities. You can come in there and be successful. Now my question is, what is Nigerian's dream? What is Nigerian's vision statement? What's so special about Nigeria? How do we see our national anthem? How do we, these are questions I sat down and I was asking myself. Branding is an essential part of life. Branding is very, very important. And I want to appeal to each and every one of you out there. Help Nigeria define its brand. Because we need you. We actually need you. So let's help Nigeria define a brand. America has a brand, so I think Nigeria can't. Nigeria can't. Thank you guys for listening. Please subscribe to my channel. If you had any questions, you can send emails to me at isnet.com. If you have any questions, you can send emails to me at isnet.com. Follow me on Twitter, Facebook, like my page, you know. Anyway, man, social media is for us all. Thank you for watching. I remain your girl.
I get it, I know it's not that easy. I know for one thing.